The next presentation is paper number 30. The title is Development of a Negative Pressure-Driven Soft Linear Actuator for Fixation Part of Wearable Assistive Devices. And so I invite the presenter of that particular paper.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you. Go ahead.
Sorry.
Yeah, that looks okay. If you take the cursor down to the bottom right, and then click on that glass-shaped image, then it will start. Okay. Sorry.
Okay.
Yeah, that's fine. Good.
So thank you, Mr. Chairman, for your warm introduction. I would like to thank you for your time today. I'm Ryuto Enjo from Chuo University in Japan. The theme of my talk is the following. Today, I would like to talk about the fixation part of wearable assistive devices. Here is the outline of my presentation. Recently, wearable assistive devices have been developed for reducing labor burdens or the declining birth rate and aging population. Such wearable devices have several parts that are fixed to the body. The fixed part is required to reliably transmit the force of the actuator to the body of the wearer. Focusing on the method of fixing the body and the device, existing fixation methods can be divided into two groups. One is wrapping a belt and hook and loop fastener. This method is easy to wear and low cost, but transmission of the force can become insufficient because it tends to slip. Another one is mold and cast. This method has reliable force transmission. It requires time to wear and the costs are high as it is custom made. So develop a fixation that achieves easy attachment and detachment and reliable force transmission will expand application of exoskeleton. So in a previous study, we proposed a fixation method using a jamming tradition that can deform based on body shape. Jamming tradition is a physical process in which the powder behaves as a solid or fluid depends on the density of the powder. When it contacts the object and increases the density, the powder became hard according to the shape of the object. Additionally, we conducted a sensory evolution experiment and compared the existing fixed part with the prototype fixed part. This experiment confirmed that the fit was better when compared to that of the existing fixed part. However, the fixation part using jamming tradition required two pneumatic systems, namely positive air pressure and negative pressure generation. Based on the result of previous research, this device has complicated operation and heavy weight. We need to develop a new device which has easy attachment and detachment, reliable force transmission, and meet the specification required for the actuator used for the fixation part. Therefore, the goal of this study is developing a negative pressure-driven linear actuator for the fixation part to simplify the fixing operation. Required specification of the actuator is shape adaptability to fit the body shape, lightweight, tightening force of 10 to 15 Newton, and maximum contraction over the 40%. It is determined by preliminary experiments. In the experiment, we determined enough power to fit was around 10 Newton, and we subjectively measured the upper limit range of tightening force that does not feel uncomfortable. The target contraction rate was set to satisfy that parts such as hand and feet pass through the fixed part. In particular, in case of the fixation of the calf, the highest contraction rate is required, and its value is 40%. So, figure 7 is structure view of proposed fixation methods. This actuator is divided into a frame part and jamming layer part and actuator part. The main difference from the previous research is that the calf is changed to an actuator that contracts under negative pressure. Figure 8 is the movement of the proposed method. First, your body passes through the devices, and secondly, the end of the jamming layer is then pulled with the actuator shrinking and the layer fits the body. Finally, negative pressure is applied to jamming layer and hardens. So, next slide, I'll explain its actuator part. Figure 9 is moving principle of the proposed actuator for fixation. The actuator is composed of a zigzag simplate skeleton and sponge, and it contracts when it is folded by negative pressure. It is characterized by high shrinkage and flexibility to handle curved surface and light weight. Therefore, we propose the actuator shown in figure 10. The change in the contraction force in response to pressure change is moderated by inserting a sponge between the folded structures. So to investigate the characteristics of actuator, we conducted an experiment. Five prototypes of actuator with different parameter values were prototyped. The ratio of the width and height of the sponge cross-section of each actuator is like in figure 11. The experimental setup looks like in figure 12. The actuator was placed horizontally and end was fixed. The compressor was connected to the ejector via regulator and two-port valve. A negative pressure was generated by the ejector and the actuator was activated. The pressure supplied to the actuator was maintained as constant and the contraction force and the contraction rate were measured. The contraction force was measured with digital force gauge. The displacement of actuator was measured with a ruler, and the pressure was measured using a pressure sensor. Figure 13 shows contraction force and the contraction of the height 35 and width 18 actuator, which is median height and width. The horizontal axis denotes the contractive rate and the vertical axis denotes contraction force. The lower right shows the starting point of measurement. External force is applied to the upper left and the external force then decreases. The maximum contraction of actuator 1 and the no load in figure 13 correspond to 52.5% at minus 36 kilopascal. This equals to a contraction of 85 millimeters. At minus 24 kilopascal, the shrink force was approximately 13 Newton, when the shrinkage corresponds to 40%. Therefore, the actuator satisfies the requirements for the fixation part. At minus 12 kPa, the no-load shrinkage corresponds to 39.8%. The jamming layer was considered as unable to fit the body at minus 12 kPa because the contractive force at 40% contraction was approximately zero. In the result of 1, 2, and 3, the actuator width was varied. Figure 40 shows the measurement result of the actuators, which is thin. And figure 15 shows the measurement result of the actuators, which is thick. Thus, it was confirmed that the maximum contraction didn't significantly change with width. This was because the change is width corresponds to the case where the actuators are connected in parallel. Therefore, the force at the same shrinkage was linear with respect to length. The result in 1, 4, and 5, in which the height of the actuator is varied. Figure 16 shows the measurement result of the actuator, which is low. Figure 17 shows the measurement result of the actuator, which is high. It was confirmed that increase in the height increased the maximum contraction and contractive forces. This was because the height directly affects the area of atmospheric pressure. In summary, increase in pressure increased actuator's contraction force and maximum contraction. Thus, increase in the width increased the contraction force and increase in the height and increase the force and the rate of contraction. So actuator 1, which is normal height and normal width, at minus 24 kPa applied to the actuator, the shrink is 13 Newton when the shrinkage corresponds to 40%. It meets required specification of the actuator in terms of tightening force and maximum contraction. In the future, a fixation part will be developed and tested. So the conclusion and the future and work are like this. That's all. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. Very nice, good presentation. So I invite colleagues to ask questions. Any questions to Ryu?
I have a question, if you don't mind.
Please.
Do you consider the reaction of blood pressure of a patient after this attaching of this device to human?
Thank you. Your question is, so, this actuator is the easy attachment and the detachment is considered. So, so we have not apply for the human, so we will try it. So it's okay?
Yeah, it's fine. So I think it's the interesting question, I think, yeah. So what impact this is going to have on the blood pressure of the user, I think is a relevant question. So it's interesting, yes. So you will look into that in your future work. So we are getting ready for presentation of the next presenter. It's just on time. So thank you very much, Ryan.